today we're going to look at how to use Photoshop's Photographic Toning Gradient Presets. We'll see how to get them into the gradient editor and, along with blending modes, get amazing skin tones. So we're going to apply a gradient map to this photo. But first, if you've never used Photographic Toning, there's a good chance that it is not in your gradients. So to check for that, you come up to Window, Gradients, and here you look in your gradients window, and you should see a group called Legacy Gradients. If you do not, you need to add that. It may be already there if you've used it before in some other version of Photoshop. So to add your Photographic Toning Gradients, come up to the menu on the right and come down to Legacy Gradients. And now you have a group here called Legacy Gradients. Scroll this down, and down here you're going to come to something called Photographic Toning. So these are the gradient maps that we're going to be using in this tutorial. So now I'm just going to duplicate my background, and I'm going to come down here to the bottom of the layers panel, and I'm going to choose gradient map. So first I'm going to change my blending mode to soft light and drop my opacity down to say 80 for right now. I'm going to double click on my gradient map, and here's a gradient editor. I'm going to slide down to where it says Legacy Gradients, and down further I'm going to twirl this out where it says Photographic Toning, and now here I can click on any of these gradients and I can instantly see the result. And I lower the opacity because I know that I'm not going to use this full strength, but you can sample any of these to see what you like, any of these that you feel is the look you're going for. I'm going for a warm look in this case, and so I've selected gold 2. I'm going to keep everything here the same, the gradient type solid. You can see the gradient map down here. On the left is how the tones are mapped in the shadow, and on the right here is how the tones are mapped in the highlights. Here in the middle is your midtones. I'm going to say okay. I'm going to close my properties. I'm going to come down to the opacity, and I'm going to bring that down a little bit more. It's a little bit too strong, so let's say around 40. And here's the before, here's the after. Other controls you have if you want to remove some of that effect of the gradient from the shadows, the highlight, just double click on your layer, and here's your layer style, and you can adjust your underlying layer. Say you don't want this effect in your shadows, and that's totally up to you. In this case, this is fine. I'll say okay. If you want to refine further, you can create a new layer and create a stamp visible layer. Shift Option Command E, and you can come up here to Filter, Camera Raw Filter, and you can change things like temperature if you want to make it warmer, and say okay. And for this example, there's the before, and there is the after. Do me a favor, hit that like button. It really helps the channel. I appreciate it. These Photographic Toning Gradients, they are presets that come with Photoshop. They're really great for color grading, and they can be a starting point, or you can use it completely. You can come down to the bottom of the layers panel, add another gradient map, change my blend mode to soft light. And again, I'm going to bring down my opacity to around 80. Click on my gradient map. Here is a gradient editor. We already added the legacy gradients and twirl that down to Photographic Toning. And here you can choose which of these you think you want depending on the effect that you want. Little gold look there. That's a nice look. And I think I'm going to go with Sepia Antique. I'm going to say OK. I'm going to close my gradient map, and I'm going to come down here to my opacity, bring that down to 64 or so. There is the before, and there's the after. Again, if I double click on my layer, here's my layer style, and I can remove some of that effect from the shadows. You can see that it is coming out of the shadows. Now we need to feather that effect a little bit. We're going to hold Alt and split this indicator right here, so the effect is not affecting the shadows. We can also do that if we need to on the highlights. I'm just going to say OK. There's the before, and there's the after. So we're able to get these amazing skin tones. These Photographic Toning presets are going to work with any skin tone. I'm going to come down here to the layers panel, add a gradient map, change my blend mode to soft light, You can experiment with your blend modes, change it to anything you like. I'm choosing soft light. I think it has a nice mellow effect. I'm going to change my opacity to something like 80 again. Just as a starter, click on my gradient map here in the center. Here's my gradient editor. Slide down to the legacy gradients. Twirl the photographic toning down and go through these and see what I like. Gold selenium 1. Gold copper looks good. Let's choose gold copper. We'll say okay. Close my properties. And again, if I don't want gold copper in the shadows, double click on my gradient map layer. Change the blend diff on my underline layer. And hold alt or option and split that just to take a little bit of that out of my shadows and say okay. And now I can decide how much I want to change my opacity. Take it all the way down. Say something like 50%. There's the before. And there's the after. A quick way to do color grading and get amazing skin tones. If you want more tutorials like this, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.